Whoa, so recording at this time of the day just gets this really bright glow. I don't know if I should be recording stuff in the afternoon anymore. Maybe I should just wait till nighttime and record. I don't know. It kind of turned me into a holy angel of some sort. Anyway, moving past that, this is David Kwan, and let's talk about Killer Instinct. And yeah, Killer Instinct. Wow. So I'm the wrong person to make a judgment on this game. Simply because I've never played the original Killer Instinct when it first came out on the Nintendo consoles, or in the arcades. I have no knowledge at all of what that experience was like. So even if this Killer Instinct turned out to be really awesome and whatever, I wouldn't be that hyped about it. So probably the wrong person to make a judgment on it. But I will say this. One thing I will say, it was revealed at the Microsoft conference and it was shown. And the feeling I got was like, this doesn't really feel like that unique, awesome fighter that we need. What separates this fighter from another fighter? Like, I really didn't get that sense, because all the other fighters, they have their unique identity. You know, Soul Calibur has a unique identity. Mortal Kombat has a unique identity. Even the new IP, like Injustice, even though its mechanics are so similar to Mortal Kombat, it has a unique identity. Street Fighter 4, King of Fighters, Dead or Alive, or Tekken, all these games have their unique fighting identities. Even some of the indie games, like Skullgirls, for example, has an identity. Guilty Gears, BlazBlue has an identity. Killer Instinct, I didn't get a sense of that. Like, it just looks like a generic fighting game. I'm sorry if that offends you as a Killer Instinct fan. But that's what it looked like to me, especially because the art style was so gimmicky and it seemed like just ripping off of Street Fighter 4 art style. And from what I've seen, it also looks like a terrible button masher. I'm not big into fighting games in general, so again, wrong person to make this kind of judgment, but some of the covers that I've seen is just Jonathan Holmes, for example, who's a Destructoid editor. He went there and he just started button mashing like crazy with Jago, the default character that the game is going to come with. And he just beat the crap out of whoever was trying to play strategically, and trying to really actually play the game instead of just button mashing like crazy. So I don't know. The game itself, I think they could have done better, but again, because I'm not a Killer Instinct fan, maybe I have no right to make a judgment. I will make a judgment on how this game is going to be released and priced. It's going to be a free-to-play game, which I'm not against. There's a lot of free-to-play games that I played before, and I'm just like, well, this is really cool, and I'm actually willing to put down some money on it because to support such an awesome game. So it's not that I'm against free-to-pay model, free-to-play, but Killer Instinct is a free-to-play game that comes with one character. That's free. All the other characters you have to purchase. What kind of structure is this? You know, Tekken Revolution just came out, and that's a free-to-play game, and no, it doesn't do it that way. So I don't know. So is that it? Is that you have to buy individual characters? I hope there is an option for you to just buy the full game outright so that you don't have to deal with the whole, you know, nickel and diming of the free-to-play model. So that's really weird, and that's really bothersome to me that Microsoft would take this franchise that is beloved by so many fans that play this game on the arcades and on the Nintendo consoles. Because this franchise has a cult following. People love this franchise. Honestly, not me, but people love this franchise. And to treat it this way, to just be like, oh yeah, we're going to release it free to play on the downloadable network. And it's gonna be a short game with just one character, and you're gonna have to buy all the other characters, and you're gonna have to buy upgrades. So essentially, people with the most money is gonna have the biggest advantage of the characters and the full experience. This is the wrong way to do the free-to-play model. The wrong way. And that's why I'm like, Killer Instinct really just bothers me. Not only because it doesn't look like an awesome game, because it really doesn't to me. It just looks like a pretty generic button mashing fighting game that has no identity of its own, other than the fact that it's a Killer Instinct game. So it has characters that people know and adored in the past. But it's not even the same pedigree. The developers behind this game, it's not Rare. It's not the original people who did Killer Instinct, but Double Helix. And their track record as developer is not that great. So There's a lot of things to be worried about in Killer Instinct. I don't know. I think people who are excited about this game are excited just because the Killer Instinct is the name of the game. But just looking from the game, looking at how the game is going to be released, I think this is a very problematic game. It's probably gonna be a flop. So that's my opinion. Tell me what you guys think if you watched it. Thanks for watching, and cheers.